What about the children? To ignore is so easy. So many innocent children lose the wrong way. What about the children? Remember when we were children? And if not for those who loved us and who cared enough to show us, where would we be today? You know, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, family. Welcome. Welcome to this insane asylum without walls, with walls that I call the mental house. Thank you, Yolanda, for that beautiful song too. But you know what, y'all? I saw one of the worst stories, and I'm, you know, dealing with one of the worst stories. When it comes to children, you know, I have a real extremely soft spot in my heart. And some of the things that I'm witnessing is just insane, what we are doing to our children. And they said the testament of a society is how it treats its elderly and how it treats its babies. And we have failed in both departments. And now I'm gonna, and that's in general. Now I'm gonna zoom right into a situation that I saw. Somebody sent me one of these projects. I don't know if it was in St. Louis or wherever it was. What I saw was one of the most hideous things. I saw a baby who had to get rushed to the hospital. It had 22, he had his leg broken in 22 places. And I suffered a broken back, a bunch of lacerations and whatnot, and it just the list goes on and on. You know, and I remember having, as a young person growing up, one of my cousins who was just not thinking right at the time. A guy did her so bad, She already had a lot of challenges and was abused coming into an environment where her mother was an alcoholic, okay? And her mother used to do all kinds of foul stuff to them and have men all around them and all kinds of stuff. But to make a long story short, when she was old enough and she got her boyfriend, the very first guy that she got a hold to, or got a hold of her, he used her and abused her. And just like predators do prey. And that's what happened. Keep this in my mouth. And that's what happened to my cousin. So I know how easily a woman can be manipulated. That's why I said, I really do believe when Elijah Muhammad said, you know, ain't no such thing as a no good woman unless she been made no good by no good man. And I stand by that. When you look in the prison systems and you look at all the women that are in there, usually I would say a good 98% of them are in there because some dude told them to do something. And guess what? They did it. Or he convinced them to do something that it was going to benefit them and whatnot. He left her holding the bag or, you know, put her in some stuff or even had her try to prove her love by doing something crazy. And now she ended up with time behind bars. I never seen it fail. So it looked like this woman was protecting this dude after he done beat that child like that.
Oh, my goodness.
And she looked so beat down. So beat down that I just don't really think she understand the ramifications behind what she done as a mother.
It was absolutely disgusting.
She's gonna go to jail. And she will be in jail for what she allowed to happen to that baby who subsequently died. I just want to plead with y'all that, you know, if you don't do nothing else, if you don't even want to save yourself, if you can't, understand that the child is really in a hostage situation. Can't leave if he wanted to. Can't fend for himself. So he's got to stay there, or she has to stay there, wrapped in your madness. And I'm praying that if you having somebody around your child that is molesting them, beating them, that you find a courage somewhere
to stop this animal from hurting your child. Because if you don't,
it's going to be one of the biggest things you regret. You might not feel that right now, but if you keep living, you will. To let somebody violate your child that's looking for you for all types of sustenance, looking for you for protection, looking for you for love, security, and you allow some male to destroy the child emotionally, mentally, physically, and sexually. I'm asking that you find the courage today to take yourself to a surgery on the truth house. Take yourself to some type of shelter. You'll be all right. But you cannot stay there in that type of circumstance and situation and think you're going to be sane. You have to get out. And I want y'all to, you know, I want to ask a favor of y'all, because this is something I really want to deal with on a real mental health level. I encourage y'all to send me your stories of children who are in hostage situations, and then let's go over them, and I'll, you know, we'll share with the family on the channel. Because the narcissism and the gaslighting is real, and the abuse. And then some of these children are living behind walls that's not even fit for a dog. And while we know we can't rescue them all, we can make ourselves aware of what it looks like. And remind ourselves what we got to be looking for and what our job really are as parents. So send me a video. Send me via my email. You'll see it in the description box. And we want to share it with the family and share it on the next video so we can go ahead and start a discussion about what happens in the mind of somebody that feels like children aren't really worth anything, or that they're not their possessions and not gifts. We got to get into that. So let me know what you think below, and send me your videos again at mentalhousetv@gmail.com, artistsforfreedom.anwar@gmail.com. Well, all of them are in the description box again. Thank you for being out there. Story got me so sad. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care of your babies.